please come to the podium. Mr. Tiwari, why do you wish to join civil service?
The primary reason for joining civil service is service. I want to serve my nation. Mm-hmm. And I want to give back to the society which has contributed in my evolution and development. And other reasons are financial security, job security, social recognition, and a challenging job.
So what qualities will you bring to this job?
So the primary quality I would say is my versatility. I can adapt to situations. In my 10th class, I had 11th and 12th class, I had physics, chemistry, mathematics. Then my graduation and post-graduation, I did with biotechnology. And the optional subject for civil service was philosophy. So I can adapt to various situations.
You can adapt.
Yes, sir.
Good.
And other than that, I also possess the qualities of compassion. And I appreciate the constitutional values of pluralism, diversity,
yeah,
and friendliness.
Good. So is this your first attempt?
Second and third.
Mr. Tiwari, what is happening in the UK on the Brexit issue? Every day we find that sometimes seven members of the Labour Party have quit, then some members of the Conservative Party have quit. What is happening there?
So I believe they are confused as to what should be the course of action now. In 2016, they held referendum where marginally people held that they should exit the European Union. But now they are unsure as to how to exit. They are suggesting a deal. And some of the cabinet members plus majority of parliamentarians, they are opposing that deal. So there is this possibility that the Brexit which will happen will be a no-deal Brexit, which would not be a good sign for the world.
But there are also some talks of a re-poll on this issue and also extension of the time for Brexit. The last date is 29th of March, I think, isn't it?
Yes.
They're also saying that maybe they may ask the EU to extend it. But what is the crux of the issue? Where is this? Where are the talks stuck on this?
So the main, there are two or three main issues. First is that Irish backstop mechanism as to where there should be a hard border between North Ireland and Republic of Ireland.
Correct.
And second issue is the rights of European Union citizens in Britain. And third issue was regarding payments that Britain has to make to European Union. So these are.
Now, our relations with China, there are a number of irritants in our relationship with China. Can you list some of them? On which China has been opposing us on various issues?
So, there are multiple issues between India and China. First is your unresolved border issue.
Okay,
that is the primary issue.
Right.
Then we have Pakistan's support, China's support to terrorism, indirect support to terrorism by blocking our bid to list Masood Azhar as a UN terrorist.
Yes.
Then I would say in South China Sea as well, we have our differences of opinion with China. China wants
on
to...
On what issues are we specifically against?
So China claims entire South China Sea to itself.
We basically say that the freedom of navigation has to be ensured,
yes,
right? But NSG?
Yes, sir.
Admission to NSG?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what is this CPEC and what is it, why is it of such significance for China?
So, CPEC is China-Pakistan Economic Corridor. It will link Gwadar with the Xinjiang province of China.
Okay.
And it is important for China because they want to avoid this Malacca dilemma and they want to create an alternative route so that their energy security can be ensured.
Right.
And that will be done by Pakistan.
Okay.
And it is of concern for India because of reasons like it violates territorial integrity and sovereignty of the country because it passes through POK and Gilgit-Baltistan, which we claim as ours.
Right. Now, when we talk of China, very often this concept of string of pearls comes up.
Yes.
What exactly is that?
So, a string of pearls is a strategy adopted by China to encircle India and to contain its rights.
Okay.
By creating its influence in countries like Horn of Africa, Djibouti, naval base, then Maldives, then Myanmar, Cape Verde.
Maldives, where do they have anything?
Maldives, they are increasing their stakes, like China-Maldives friendship bridge.
True.
And,
but that doesn't mean surrounding India. Basically, when we talk of string of pearls, it means, you know, naval bases from where China can pose a threat to India. It means their warships can come there. So Maldives, they don't have anything yet.
in future, sir, it can happen.
Yeah,
US,
they're trying to buy an island which was didn't go through.
And Chinese submarine presence is also because of
that. Okay. Now tell me, is there a procedure laid down for removal of Supreme Court judges in the Constitution?
Sir, Constitution provides for removal of Supreme Court judges. And it has to happen
on what grounds? On what grounds? Two grounds, gentlemen.
I can't recall.
Bhuvan is very.
Bhuvan means whether incapacity.
And incapacity. Now, the procedure to remove a Supreme Court judge is laid down in the Judges Inquiry Act. What is that?
What is the
procedure?
So, the initiation of resolution has to happen at either of the two houses.
Mm-hmm.
Then, it has to be passed by at least 2/3 of members present and voting and 50% of the membership of the House.
They vote without any inquiry?
First inquiry has to be committed as well.
Yeah.
And the speaker will admit it. The speaker or chairperson will admit it. And then it will be sent.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. If I say our preamble to the Constitution,
yes,
sums up the whole Constitution, how would you justify this?
I believe the statement is correct because it contains the ideals and aspirations of a country that we want to be. It provides for creating a country that is sovereign, secular and democratic and a republic form of country, and it seeks to provide for its citizens justice, that is social, economic, political, equality of status and opportunity, and liberty, thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, and to create a integrated society which has solidarity amongst its members.
You have okay, now you tell us where in the Constitution we see imprints of this. When you talked of justice,
yes,
you said social, economic, political.
Yes.
Is this where do you see social, economic and political justice in the Constitution?
Sir, it is primarily in case of fundamental rights and DPSP, that is the principle of state policy. Fundamental rights, they talk about political justice, and DPSP about social and economic justice.
Okay. What is 73rd and 74th Amendment?
The 73rd and 74th Amendment deal with rural local bodies and urban local bodies.
Anything very salient features of these amendments?
Sir, they provide for subjects that relate to grassroots levels, which directly concern the citizens, to be administered and governed by the rural local bodies. They empower the panchayats and urban local bodies so that citizens can interact with them and resolve their grievances. And we have 11th and 12th schedule as well, which lays down certain subjects of important
concern. Right to Education Act.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell us about some of the salient features of this?
The Right to Education Act, it provides for free and compulsory primary education for children in the age group 6 to 14 years in age appropriate classroom. Then earlier it used to contain unfair detention provision, but now it has been amended, and now states have been given the responsibility, the authority to decide whether they want to have unfair detention provision in the state. And it seeks to provide quality education as well by the provision of comprehensive and continuous evaluation.
How does it ensure that all students, given the population we have, are there are sufficient schools to accommodate all everybody, even the poor?
It provides for minimum infrastructure norms that has to be there in schools, and then schools has to be in a certain distance, and then there is reservation of 25% for
private schools. That is the point. Now, last, tell us about. In the recent past, Uttarakhand High Court passed a number of judgments touching upon forest and wildlife. Can you tell us about some of them?
Sir, in 2017, Uttarakhand High Court passed a judgment declaring River Ganga and its tributaries as a living entity. Then the
subsequent to that has been stayed by.
And last year, Uttarakhand High Court passed a judgment where animals, they were listed as
juristic entities.
Yeah, juristic entities, yes. With rights and duties.
Okay, thank you. Think about it.
Uttarakhand sees a lot of floods and landslides in the upper areas, upper regions. So what is being done to look into this problem?
Regarding floods, we are, you know, after 2013 Kerala tragedy, we have initiated certain projects like Uttarakhand Disaster Recovery Project, which is World Bank supported project. Then there is
what is being done in it?
We are creating the infrastructure so that we can deal with floods and flash flood type situations. And then we are also creating awareness. Then we are promoting organic farming, renewable sources of energy. And we are also, Union government also has passed order declaring certain areas as economically sensitive areas where certain development activities will be restricted.
So in these areas like you just mentioned, where the temples and all are situated, is there any restriction on the movement or visitors? So you talked of disasters. Do we have any agency which looks after this problem? Any disaster relief?
We have, for relief situations, we have NDRF and National Disaster Response Force, State Disaster Response.
So are they the first people who come for relief, or is it the locals who come for relief?
Locals.
So what is their good?
And they have to, first of all, they have, like in case of forest fires, they have to be given certain amount of training so that they can deal with it.
No, I was talking about the disaster relief forces. What is their good? If the locals are already doing what is required, then why do we need these agencies or relief forces?
In certain disasters, they may not be handled by locals.
Mm-hmm.
And in that cases, NDRF and SDRF role becomes important. Like
So how was their role in looking into the floods or the landslides in the last event that happened?
They played a very important role.
What did they do?
They evacuated people, then they carried out search and rescue operations. They transferred people to medical facilities and they provided first aid and all those things. Then they dropped food packets as well.
So in future, if there's a flood or landslide of the scale at which we had earlier, do you think the people themselves will be able to manage?
Ma'am, people's capability have to be built, but we have to bank upon NDRF and SDRF as well.
Now you have philosophy as a subject. If I asked you to compare the philosophies of Buddhism and Jainism, would you be able to do that?
Yes, ma'am.
Let's hear.
Ma'am, Jainism, they have some kind of bias against absolutism.
Mm-hmm.
For them, everything is relative. They believe in philosophy of Syatva, theory of relativity of truth. Whereas Buddhism, they say that this perceptual world is conditional and finite. But there is absolute reality which is bodhi or pragya. So they have no bias against absolutism. Then Buddhism, they don't believe in any entity like Siddhashila. Whereas Jainism, they say that once you have attained moksha, you will go to Siddhashila and you will have fourfold bliss, knowledge, power, bliss and faith. So Buddhism has no such concept. For them, once you have been liberated from cycle of birth and death, it will be like a candle has been vanished and the flame will not go anywhere. You cannot make
sense. Now, you also are interested in meditation. So what sort of meditation do you do in Vipassana?
I practice mindful breathing meditation.
What is mindful breathing? Everyone talks these days of mindfulness. What is it?
Mindful breathing, we observe our inhalation and exhalation processes.
Mm-hmm.
We focus on that.
So why don't you just call it breathing exercises and concentration on that?
Yes, it can be called that.
It could be called that. Alright. You've also done biotechnology.
Yes.
So what do you study in biotechnology? Do you do stem cells?
Yes.
So tell me the latest on stem cell research.
Stem cells, they are progenitor cells which can develop into any kind of cell. And
yes,
there are multiple kind of stem cells, totipotent stem cell, multipotent stem cell and pluripotent stem cells. And stem cells...
So can you grow organs from a stem cell?
Yes, it is possible. Totipotent stem cell, they can be used to develop any kind of organ. And pluripotent, limited number of organs can be developed.
So has it been used
anywhere? Stem cell therapy has been used in tissue regeneration in certain cases.
I read of a ear being grown, correct? Ear, outer ear, the ear lobe.
Yes, it is possible.
It is possible. Alright. Now you also done under biotechnology, do you also study those machines in biotechnology? Like CT machines, the MR machines, What else do you study?
The primary area is the area which I am comfortable is that downstream processing, nanofiltration and reverse osmosis.
So as far as nano is concerned, can we use that technology to give drugs in certain areas, specific areas, delivery of drugs?
Nanotechnology, it can be used.
It can be used. Is it being used?
No.
I think now they are for cancer, they are doing that.
Deepak, some people have described Gandhi as a Marxist without a gun. Would you agree?
Sir, I believe Gandhiji stood for certain principles that were common than Marxism, like welfare of all the people and Sarvodaya and Antyodaya. But he differed with Marxism in certain ways, like Marxism, he was not, I would say, compatible with the idea of blood revolution. He believed in Satyagraha, that is non-violent revolution, using the force of soul to change the people.
Now, which emergency provision of the constitution is yet to be invoked? Which emergency provision of the constitution is yet to be invoked?
Financial emergency under Article 360.
And which is the one which has been invoked the most and abused the most also, according to some?
Precedence under Article 356.
Okay. Now, in the same context, the governor of a state has certain discretionary power when there is a hung assembly in terms of inviting who he thinks would command a majority. Now, which was the last case where this exercise of this power was challenged and Supreme Court issued some orders?
Sir, it happened last year in Karnataka assembly elections.
Okay. So what was the nature of the Supreme Court's direction?
So Honorable Supreme Court, directed the governor to hold the confidence motion within 48 hours instead of 15 days. So time was reduced.
Okay. Now, some question on, you have been following the Indian economy. Can you name two positive and two negative trends of the Indian economy?
Over the last few years?
Currently.
So positive trend, I would say first positive trend I have seen recently is increased collections of tax, direct taxes.
What I've seen tax rates.
Tax base has increased from 3.8 crores to 6.8 crores.
Okay.
And tax revenues have also increased. Tax to GDP, direct tax to GDP ratio, it has increased to 5.98%.
And
other positive that I find is GST, which has led to...
It's again tax. So mention something which is fundamental, macroeconomically fundamental.
So over the last few years, average inflation rate, it has been less than 4.5%.
Yeah.
So that is, and economic growth rate is of average 7.4%.
So that is something. So these are the positive trends. What about the negative trends?
So one of the negative trends is inequality. According to Oxfam report,
that's a social phenomenon. I'm asking about economic trends, fiscal trends, macroeconomic trends.
I would say it is low investment to GDP ratio. It should be higher. It should be higher to support 10% plus economic growth rate.
Yeah.
It should be at the range of 35-36%. But it is currently voting at around 32%, so it should be
okay.
And other is your tax to GDP ratio is still, I would say, not to the level of China or OECD countries. It can be higher.
Okay. What about trade deficit?
Yes, that is also one of the concerns. Especially with current account deficit and trade deficit is one of the matters of concern for us.
Okay. What is the Kartarpur corridor?
The Kartarpur corridor is a joint initiative between India and Pakistan, wherein the Sikh pilgrims, they will be able to visit Kartarpur Sahib Gurudwara in Pakistan.
Okay. And it will connect which place in in India, Gurdaspur to Gurdaspur. Given the situation that we are passing through as far as Indo-Pak relations is concerned, do you think these corridors should be kept on hold? Is it liable to be misused by some people, this facility?
Some possibility of misuse is there, but it is not a viable reason to keep it on hold, because the faith of Sikh pilgrims is of utmost importance.
Okay. Now, you take interest in cricket. You watched yesterday's match?
Yes.
What was the difference between a victory for India and a defeat for India?
So I would say it is the individual brilliance of grandmaster.
Okay. Very good. Thank you.
Alright, you are interested in foreign service as your second choice. Prime Minister Modi, after the Pulwama incident, made a statement that the military has been given a free hand. Now, do you think as a diplomat, as an officer of foreign service, should military be given a free hand? Should it be allowed to do what it likes?
The military can be given free hand within the constitutional framework. And military should not degenerate
in the context of Indo-Pak relations. Should military be given a free hand?
Sir, I believe what Prime Minister was referring to was retaliatory to what Pakistan has done. But we are not a country like Pakistan where military can govern the entire country. So, the kind of free hand that military has in Pakistan that we cannot.
You are not answering my question. Should military have a free hand as far as India-Pakistan relations are concerned? You already do what you like. I am sitting with my eyes closed.
Sir, we cannot.
Obviously. Now, last year there was some action of the governor of Uttarakhand, which was rejected by the Supreme Court. Do you have any idea?
Second of
Uttarakhand?
I cannot recall that.
You don't recall that incident?
I don't recall the actual.
Dr. K.K. Paul was is still the governor?
He was
the governor. And he had tried to intervene in a matter which was purely within the realm of the speaker. You have no idea.
Sir, right now, governor is this baby running.
No, it's okay, but I'm talking about last year. All right, never mind. Is Uttarakhand a special category state?
Yes, sir.
What does that mean, special category?
Sir, special category state is given to a state. Special category status is given to a state based upon certain parameters like border state, then geographical terrain difficulty, then economic backwardness, and so Uttarakhand meets all these criteria. So
what benefit does it derive from the center, which other states don't derive?
Sir, they receive more funding as compared to normal states. 30% of central funds they are given to 11 special category states, and when it comes to irrigation projects as well, so they receive funds.
In centrally sponsored scheme, they get 90% as against 60% in other states. That is the real advantage they get. You are a foreign service aspirant. Name two main objectives of India's foreign policy. That is what it is trying to achieve through foreign policy.
So first is promotion of national security.
National security as well.
And second is India's development by furthering its, improving its relations with other countries.
Okay, good. You are quite good, right? You know what is BRI, Belt and Road Initiative of China? So under this it has launched some connectivity schemes. India is also responding and has started certain connectivity schemes. Can you identify those schemes, India's schemes?
One is, sir, India and Japan, they have talked about Asia-Africa Growth Corridor.
No, you talk of something which is actually on the ground.
One is Chabahar Port Project. then Kaladan multimodal project,
mm-hmm.
and India-Myanmar-Thailand trilateral highway,
good.
And BCI, Bangladesh-China-India-Myanmar corridor, and BBI.
Which is of course is still not taken off. But all these have, others have trilateral, Kaladan and Chabahar. Right. What is Kaladan? Where does it begin? And where does it end?
Kaladan will start from Kolkata port, then it will connect Sitwe port, and then it will pass through Myanmar and connect Mizoram.
In biotechnology, what do you study?
Sir, biotechnology, if I can define it, it is application of technological process on biological systems and organisms to manipulate organisms.
Biological means living organisms.
Living
right?
organisms.
Whether it is plant or it is
microbes.
So do you deal with the GM crops?
Yes.
What is the state of GM crops in India?
Sir, as of now, BT cotton is allowed to be cultivated. And when it comes to GM mustard, no decision has been taken of now. GAC has given it green light to allow it commercial cultivation, but Environment Ministry has not taken a decision as of now.
And why hasn't Environment Ministry taken a decision?
Sir, because they believe that the impact of GM mustard on biodiversity and plant and animal health is still not.
They are very keen to legitimize it. Supreme Court is putting its foot down. Mr. Modi is very keen to release the GM mustard. Dr. Pentel's what is the difference between genetics and biotechnology?
So genetics, genetics is one of the branches under biotechnology.
I see.
So we study genetics as
so
a part of
cloning, etc. will be part of biotechnology?
Yes, so we study it under biotechnology.
I see. And when you change the genes, that also is part of?
Yes, genetic engineering is also.
I see. Now, Uttarakhand, after the incident in what was that place?
Kedarnath. Yes.
Then, construction of dams has been halted in Uttarakhand. A large number of dams.
Yes.
Who has halted it and why?
Sir, the activism that has happened after 2013 floods, it has contributed to halting of certain hydroelectric projects.
Yeah, all right, activism, there are behaviors and all. But which is the authority which has said no, we will not allow it until certain conditions are met? Supreme Court. Government of India and Uttarakhand government are very keen to launch. But Supreme Court says no. We must have a proper study, ecological effect. You must know these are important. Now Uttarakhand is a border state. So Bharat Mala program must be functional there, Bharat Mala. What is this program and what work has been done as far as Uttarakhand is concerned?
Sir, I'm not aware of
what? You don't
projects,
know what is Bharat Mala?
Projects under Bharat Mala.
But you know what is Bharat Mala? It is meant to develop border roads right from Gujarat to Manipur. All the border states. Alright, we close the interview. I'll give you feedback. You have done well. You have been able to handle most questions nicely. We feel that questioning will be based on your
biodata.
In case you wish to write, otherwise you will get it. So most questioning will be based on your biodata. So you are from Uttarakhand, philosophy is your subject, foreign service is your second choice, biotechnology, etc. are your study, main subjects, then meditation, reading books, watching cricket. We feel it is these areas on which you should focus. We have tried to ask you questions. You will get a video outside which will give you a full, which captures the entire sequence of events of this interview. In addition, we feel that constitutional principles should also be studied, like 73, 74 amendments. Then socio-economic political justice, what are the laws and institutions for it? The country.
since Kedarnath event happened, so disaster management has become a major issue. So it can be asked, what are the mechanism for disaster management in India? Philosophy is your subject, therefore we have asked you a few questions. Gandhi, Marxism, Jainism, Buddhism, etc. So these are some of the areas, and finally current affairs. Special sadhana. इतना करने के आपने I think you will be very well informed. उत्तराखंड पे काफी करें, भारत माला जरा देख लीजिए program. What is the budget allocation for it? And how much work is being done in your state? Rest is all okay.
Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.